How do you guys get into character?
Do you know what? It's just do the voice, and it sounds terrible, doesn't it? Because there's some roles where you really have to think about it. But I'm, you know, I just did the voice.
It was kind of a little bit like when you got in that studio on your own. It was a bit, if I say, I don't mean to sound pretentious, but like you're channeling your inner child. But do you know what I mean? You just kind of got in there and got a bit silly. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of just, it was quite liberating, and you just kind of did your voice.
Do your voices muck about.
And be quite free with it.
Yeah,
though, as well,
you have to
it?
Go into a bit of a zone to do it.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
You didn't go into much of a zone, though, because you just sat down.
I did it sitting. She's really annoyed with me because basically I asked for a chair.
I worked up a sweat.
Yeah.
When I was in that studio.
No, not me.
So I would come out exhausted.
Not me.
You were actually leaping around like a frog.
I actually was leaping around like a frog.
Oh. And it shows in your performance.
That's how committed I was. Yeah. I always wore green.
Mm.
When I was
working.
No, I didn't really.
And you ate passing flies?
Passing.
Or was that a toad?
When you got involved with this movie, how was it pitched to you?
Romeo and Juliet, straight away, that title says...
It rung a bell somewhere.
Yeah, just... No,
spoke
but,
to you, yeah?
No, I'm not trying to be facetious, but just straight away you get the tone of it.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah.
You know, you go, okay, this isn't going to take itself too seriously, but this is obviously going to be inspired by Romeo and Juliet.
Mm-hmm.
And then I knew that it had Elton's music in it.
Mm-hmm. And it just seemed to have all the ingredients of something that was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And since we've seen the film, and the colours are just absolutely, the colours are really vivid, aren't they? You can tell by the poster.
Yeah.
It's really beautiful colours, and the detail in the animation. I mean, we were just saying that we sort of trip in as the actors and do the voices at the 11th hour. But these people have been working on it for 5 years, and the expressions on the faces are just really cute, aren't they?
Was the 11th hour the name of the film
that
you did
with
Patrick Stewart?
That was the thing that I did with Patrick Stewart.
So you played Patrick Stewart's,
Bodyguard.
Yeah.
I carried
Bodyguard,
a gun.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Was Kevin Costner to Whitney Houston?
It was.
We're now. Why does Patrick Stewart need a bodyguard?
He needed one because he was a science head.
Did he need one just for show?
So he's a science man.
He was a science
so
man.
A bodyguard?
That couldn't. He needed a bodyguard because he dug into all sorts of controversial.
Right.
Controversial issues.
Okay, so they're casting bodyguards, and there's obviously Mr. T. Like, really, and then they cast you as a bodyguard. No disrespect.
Yeah, Ricky,
you're very versatile. You're very versatile, but they cast you as a bodyguard.
See, I would quite like to do a very serious drama with somebody like you.
Yeah, well, that ain't going to happen.
Would you ever do a serious drama?
Well, no one will give me the opportunity.
I think
to do
they
a
should.
Drama.
I would love to see you doing.
Really?
You and I could play something like Brothers and Sisters. Oh, look, come on, right? Here we go.
Sorry.
Right,
go on.
No, I was enjoying it very much. I was just being a bit of a wanker, really.
No, you weren't.
No.
No, you weren't. No, you weren't.
Stop
Don't put yourself down. Come on.
I'm sorry.
Look at his lovely curls.
I like them.
Yeah. Really, I like them.
You remind me of a young Greek boy. Actually, you remind me of, what's that film with...
Romeo and Juliet.
Death in Venice. You're like the boy in Death in Venice.
Right, anyway, come on, let's get
sorry,
back to the...
Sorry.
No, I'll ask a hard-hitting, serious journalism question.
Okay. Empire, ask us a question about fucking Star Wars. Go on, about the Star Wars trilogy.
What's your favourite Star Wars character?
Jar Jar Binks, next. Lando Calrissian.
Yeah, I'm 100% serious.
100% serious. I was like, Star Wars, ooh, and I thought, oh, boring.
Yeah.
But actually, I went to see it and I quite enjoyed it.
I like Wicket W. Warwick.
Warwick Davis?
Is that Warwick Davis?
He was in Star Wars, wasn't he?
He was, yeah.
He's in everything,
Jedi,
though, isn't he?
Yeah.
But you don't have a favourite character?
Chewbacca.
I like the one that looks like C-3PO, but isn't. It's like there's one that you sort of see.
Oh, what, in the background?
Yeah, I like the ones in the background. I like the Cantina Band. Sorry,
oh, yeah, they're great.
What did you want to ask us?